women, youth, and advisors who can assist in the promotion of peace, unity, and community enhancement, coupled with the essential tools of civility and responsibility. Now, therefore, be the resolution of the undersigned that October 2011 is hereby recognized as Volunteers Against Violence Month in Spartanburg County, and call upon all citizens of Spartanburg County and upon all religious, civic, and educational organizations to observe this month and join together to make our community a leader in the mission of the Volunteers Against Violence and to end the plague of violence in our community.
Amen.
Adopted the 17th day of October 2011, attested by Spartanburg County Council, signed by Jeffrey A. Gordon, Chairman, of course, attested by Anne Arundel County Administrator Nelson Mark Young. I would entertain a motion.
So moved.
Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, it passes.
Thank you, gentlemen. I present this to Ms. Tamara Smith. If you would like to say something on behalf of this effort, and indeed your family, please do it this time.
On behalf of our family, we thank you so much for this acknowledgement. It's going to be a hard road as the trial comes up. It's going to open new wounds or old wounds as well. I'm pretty sure that my brother won't be recognized as the greatest man in the world as the fence, but he was a great man, and he was a great father, and he was a great son, and for me, he was a great brother.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you all, and I've been informed to the volunteers. The business portion of this meeting won't take long, so if you can stick around, we want to have a word of prayer outside when we are finished with council business. Thank you for that.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. I would like to take one for the order and just comment on Mr. Brown. I think Mr. Brown not only read these words today, he walked the walk, he worked with a lot of individuals throughout this community. So I'm very proud of Michael. I think Michael's a success story that we all can look up to Michael Brown. Thank you, Mr. Brown. Next, we have a resolution recognizing Rolling Thunder Incorporated, SC Chapter 2, in its efforts to support and educate citizens about prisoners of war and missing in action. Ms. Faye Smith here to receive the resolution. Mr. Michael Cromer, President of Rolling Thunder Chapter 2, to make a special presentation.
We'll ask Mr. Cromer and his members to join me, as well as Ms. Smith. You know, over 40 years ago, there was a young man from this community who, at the age of 23, was a 1960 graduate of Carver High School, was a part of a four-man Huey helicopter crew that disappeared in Vietnam on December 28, 1965. He was officially declared killed in action on December 29, 1966. But unfortunately, any signs of any remains were never recovered over a 40-year period. It wasn't until last year that the family, and Ms. Smith is here, gained some closure in terms of what happened to their brother from Spartanburg. Family wondered whether Mr. Rice had been captured, whether he was a prisoner of war, if he had died in a crash, or he had been taken in some unknown manner. Family wondered forever. 2006, those efforts in terms of organizations that would work to find similarly situated individuals began successful efforts. And last year, there was a group burial service for Mr. Rice and his crewmates that was held in our most prestigious and honorable cemetery for fallen service members, the Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia. And to recognize there were other members of the Huey 808 crew. They included Army Chief Warrant Officer Kenneth L. Stansel of Chattanooga, Tennessee, Chief Warrant Officer Jesse D. Phelps of Boise, Idaho, and Specialist Donald C. Griller of Laurel, Nebraska. After this collective group service, the remains of Soldier Rice were buried in Arlington. I've known Mr. Cromer for a few years, and this young man let me know that he was a part of an organization that recognizes both our POWs, our prisoners of war, and those who are missing in action. And at the time we began having conversations, I didn't know he knew Ms. Smith. And Ms. Smith and I began having conversations shortly thereafter, the memorial service that was held here in terms of the funeral for her brother in Spartanburg, and after he was buried in Arlington, in terms of efforts of just having the community know that this great man had died in service of his country, and that he was from Spartanburg. So with that, I want to present a resolution, and I know Mr. Cromwell will come in his own way, but I'm going to present this resolution to Ms. Smith. Rolling Thunder worked hand in hand with Ms. Smith and her family, and I see other family members are here today, and I just want to say thank you for being here. But in particular, I want to read this resolution. Recognizing Rolling Thunder Incorporated, South Carolina Chapter 2, and its efforts to support and educate citizens about the prisoners of war and those missing in action. Whereas, through all wars, Spartanburg County sons and daughters have answered the call of their nation to defend our freedoms in foreign lands. During these wars, many have paid the ultimate sacrifice. Many have returned home wounded, and others have been held as prisoners of war or have been classified as missing in action. Whereas Rolling Thunder Incorporated, South Carolina Chapter 2, is a nonprofit organization whose mission is to publicize the POW-MIA issue, to educate the public that many Americans were left behind after all past wars, and to help correct the past and to protect the future veterans from being left behind should they become POW or MIAs. Whereas Rolling Thunder Incorporated was instrumental in the passage of Public Law 101-355 during the 101st session of Congress to designate the National League of Families POW-MIA flag as a symbol of our nation's concern and commitment to resolving as fully as possible the fates of Americans still prisoner, missing, and unaccounted for in Southeast Asia, thus ending the uncertainty for the families and the nation. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Spartanburg County Council does hereby encourage us all to honor those who gave all, to remember those who were held captive, and to remember the families of our missing in action, and to live by the motto, we will not forget. Amen. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be presented to Faye Smith in recognition thereof and be made part of the permanent minutes of the Spartanburg County Council adopted this 17th day of October 2011, signed by County Council Chairman Jeffrey A. Horton, and attested by Nelson Marchioli, Interim County Administrator. Entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second. We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? In favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, it passes. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much. Smith. Thank you.
Before we received an answer, but I'm quite sure they had the answer before we did. It's been a long battle. We never gave up hope. because we were never given anything, so we always felt like he was maybe just a prisoner of war. With that being said, again, thank the community for everything and the people that reached out to us to help us get to Arlington for the services that we attended. And thanks again for the support. We will be renaming, if I'm not mistaken, Holland Avenue.
All right.
It's going to be renamed in his honor this week.
Glory.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. If I could take a few minutes for the council time, I appreciate the opportunity to come speak with y'all today. I would like to kind of introduce y'all to who Woven Thunder is. I know a lot of people hear the name and don't really know what to do. General George Washington in 1789 made the following statement. The willingness with which our young people are likely to serve in any war, no matter how justified, shall be directly proportional as to how they perceive that veterans of earlier wars were treated and appreciated by their country. In 1987, a group of Vietnam veterans who had served honorably were deeply troubled by the neglect of attention given to those who didn't make it home alive or with their freedoms. At this time, there had been approximately 10,000 sightings of live Americans living in visible captivity. These were generally ignored by the government and mainstream press. In 1988, these men decided to have their rights and have their voices heard and demonstrated at the nation's capital. Their arrival would be announced by the noise of their motorcycles, not unlike the 1965 bombing campaign against North Vietnam, dubbed Operation Rolling Thunder. Hence that little name and title would endure and be trademarked in 1990. The 1988 protest brought 2,500 motorcycles to protest and demand a full accounting of all our POWs and MIAs. That day, the foundation was laid for the current ride to the wall on Memorial Day. In 2009, we had in excess of 970,000 motorcycles and 1.1 million people in attendance. This is a protest, it is not a parade. We're wanting full accountability of all our people. Rolling Thunder Incorporated is not a motorcycle club, although we do ride them. We have members who are state workers, retired school teachers, current teachers, past law enforcement, veterans, non-veterans. Some ride motorcycles, trikes, cars, trucks, antique vehicles, and at least one motor scooter. But these old members all have something in common, and that is that every prisoner of war and missing in action has a right be brought home.
That's right.
Rolling Thunder spends hundreds of thousands of dollars each year in financial aid for food and clothing to veterans and homeless vets and veterans' families in need and crisis centers and toys for children. In 2007, Rolling Thunder Charities was established as a 501(c) tax-exempt nonprofit organization which enables individuals and corporations to receive tax donations for funds donated to Rolling Thunder. No officer to Rolling Thunder receive any compensation. We all donate our time. 100% of donations go directly to veterans. The Rolling Thunder Inc. and sponsor search missions in the Southeast Asia for POWs and MIAs and remains of those killed in action. Last year, just over $500,000 we donated to the Joint POW-MIA Accounting Committee, which is known as JPAC. JPAC has the largest DNA forensics lab in the world. They're in Florida, in Hawaii, and they are directly responsible for uncovering the crash site of Thomas Rice Jr.